Welcome back to Top Story. As we reported earlier, Malaysian authorities are still trying to convince about 100 Filipinos, some of them armed, to return home from Sabah. The Filipinos have so far refused to be deported, saying that by order of Sulu Sultan Jamalul Kiram, they have a historic claim over the territory. And for more on this, we're joined on the line by Dr. Renato De Castro of De La Salle University's International Studies Department. Dr. De Castro, magandang hapon po.
Good evening. How are you doing?
I'm fine. Thank you very much for joining us on Top
Story. How are you doing?
I'm fine. Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Yes. The issue here as to whether or not the heirs of the Sultan of Sulu and their family actually still have a claim to Sabah is supposedly buttressed by rent payments or rental payments being paid by the Malaysian government to their family. At this point, does that seem to be at least a solid basis for the Sultanate of Sulu to say that their claim to Sabah is still valid?
We are now in the world of territorial states. We don't have any more of those petty kingdoms. So I think it's, dealing with, it's a private claim that they have to pursue with, the Malaysian government, the Malaysian state. Whether it's valid or not, I think it's to be tested, challenged in terms of international court, private international law.
Mm-hmm. In this sense,
it is a sort of a gray area here, where of course they're claiming their the Sabah on the basis of historic, which doesn't stand in international law at this point in time.
Mm-hmm. So in this sense, when the Sultan of Sulu at this point, Jamalul Kiram, is saying that their family still receives rent payment from the Malaysian government. On a private basis. That rent payment is just a recognition of the Sultan, the family's ownership of that place, of that territory, but not a sovereign claim by the Philippines.
I guess so. I guess that's the case. Mm-hmm. I think it's be wise for the Philippine government to kind of stay away from this issue. It's an issue between a private claim by the Sultanate of Sulu against the Malaysian government.
Uh-huh. Now, with the DFA, as we spoke earlier to its spokesperson, Assistant Secretary Raul Hernandez, is saying that the Philippine claim to Sabah is still what? What was the term he used? I think he says it's still pending. And in that sense, is the Philippine government, do you think, still in a good position to pursue that claim?
I don't think so. Malaysia has effectively administered Sabah since the 1960s.
Mm-hmm.
So it basically strengthens Malaysian position when you talk in terms of administration. That's, of course, the basis in international law. This claim is failed there, but whether it will stand up in the International Court of Justice, of course, is another matter.
Right. Well, of course, there are differing views from some analysts who've also given their opinions in public about this issue, and they're saying that the Philippine government should really keep that claim, even if we're shelled in the meantime, but still keep that claim alive. You're saying now the Philippine government should just stay away from any territorial claims to Sabah if mm-hmm. came from any Filipino
side. We have other concerns.
Mm-hmm.
I think we have other concerns. And I think this issue will just create more problems for us. I think we should focus more on the bigger picture rather than go back to this irritant in mm-hmm. Philippine-Malaysian relations and mm-hmm. also problems within ASEAN.
Mm-hmm.
It's time that we have to settle this with Malaysia diplomatically, once and for all.
Now, would it seem that by not giving any support to, some Filipinos who also feel that they have been unjustly aggrieved or have been unfairly treated by another country, that the Philippine government is actually...
We're not treating them any better, I guess.
Uh-huh.
We're not treating them any better, I guess.
In what way?
Especially those in the southern part of Mindanao.
Mm-hmm.
So why point the fingers at the Malaysians for not treating them well, whereas even our government itself is not treating them that well?
Mm-hmm. Are you referring to the people in the southern Philippines in general, or just the family
yes.
of Sultan
yes.
Kiram?
Oh, yeah, I think they have people in Sulu area.
Mm-hmm. So in this case, when the Philippine government says that they want to resolve it through negotiations, the family of or the armed supporters of Sultan Kiram saying that they will not leave Sabah, do you expect that the Philippine government should just stand aside and let the Malaysian authorities use whatever means?
Well, they entered into a sovereign state. We cannot afford to be accused of intervening in Malaysian domestic affairs.
So,
how would we react if you have the Malaysians also intervening our domestic affairs in Mindanao?
Well, I guess that's also an issue that's sort of like an irritant between the Philippines and Malaysia, because we still have the Aman Futures founder, Manuel Amalillo, there in Sabah. And in a way, the Malaysian government has hindered attempts to bring Amalillo back to the Philippines to face justice.
I think there's also a domestic issue regarding this case in regards to Sabah. Yeah, well, that's a complication in Philippine-Malaysian relations with our neighbor. And it has to be resolved diplomatically and it has to be managed carefully.
Mm-hmm. So we can't...
Well, you have to also take into account that the Malaysia played a very important role in the recent peace settlement between the Philippine government and the Moro Islamic Liberation Front.
Right. So that being the case,
we have to bear that in mind.
So that being the case, the Philippine government should, now, as you're advising it, should just stay away from this issue and let the Malaysian authorities handle it the best way they can.
Handle it with much prudence.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the best approach there is, as Henry Kissinger said, in certain situations, you simply have to do nothing.
Mm. All right. Well, Dr. De Castro, we certainly hope that the situation in Sabah will be resolved, even if the Philippine government side will just handle it through negotiations, or as you said, maybe by not doing anything.
Mm-hmm.
But in the meantime, thank you very much for speaking with us on Top Stories.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay.
In other Top Stories today, the Department of Health is on the lookout for cases of the new coronavirus in the Philippines.